Mr. Wilson, a momentous summit session ahead with Rhodesia's Ian Smith, prepared to board an RAF Comet at London Airport. With Mrs. Wilson to see him off, the Prime Minister, accompanied by Commonwealth Secretary Herbert Bowden and the Attorney General Sir Elwin Jones, was en route to Gibraltar and secret talks in a bid to end the Rhodesian crisis. The cloak of secrecy, which had been intended to shroud the meeting, had, earlier the same day, been torn aside when Mr. Smith was spotted by a pressman at Salisbury Airport. Now the whole world knew. Ian Smith, also in an RAF Comet, was already on his way towards their rendezvous, the Rock. There, anchored offshore after a dash from Casablanca, was the Navy's crack cruiser HMS Tiger, destined to be a vital boardroom of international politics. Over the past 13 months, talks, negotiations, sanctions, and other pressures had not been able to divert Mr. Smith from the path of UDI. When he came to Britain last year to meet Mr. Wilson for emergency talks, there seemed hope of settlement. But this was not to be. The London talks failed. Mr. Wilson, anxious that the problem should not develop into a world crisis, went to Rhodesia. His reception was cordial. But even this meeting failed to provide a solution. Mr. Smith made his fateful decision. But Rhodesia lacked the vital lifeblood, oil. Her lifeline was cut. Petrol was rationed. Friend and neighbor, South Africa, saw that she did not go too short. At the London meeting of Commonwealth Prime Ministers, feelings ran high. African representatives demanded strong action from Mr. Wilson. Like Winston Churchill, who cemented the Atlantic Pact at sea in 1941, Harold Wilson went to sea in 1966.